I worship you today. You are wewe ni Mungu wa miungu, hakuna mwingine kama wewe. Wewe ni ushindi wa maisha yetu Bwana. We worship Jehovah Elohim. We lift our hands, Hallelujah. We glorify the Lord. We exalt your name, King Jesus. You are the Alpha and Omega. We worship you today, Lord.
No one else like you, Lord. The beginning and the end. We worship you, King of Glory. We worship you, Lord of Lords.
We worship you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We praise your name, O God. We praise your name, Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Are you ready to praise the Lord with me? Let me hear my joyful shout. Bwana wa majeshi leo ainuliwe. Bwana wa mabwana ainuliwe. Bwana
wa majeshi leo ainuliwe.
Bwana
wa mabwana ainuliwe.
Bwana wa majeshi leo ainuliwe. Bwana wa mabwana ainuliwe. Bwana
Bwana
anayetupenda sana ainuliwe. Bwana wa majeshi. Yesu ni ya juu. Ya juu, ya juu, ya juu, ya juu, ya juu. Ainuliwe Mungu wetu leo. Ainuliwe wana wa mabwana. Ametenda mambo ya ajabu. Utukufu na sifani zake ainuliwe.
That you have given unto us. We thank you, Lord, for giving us yet another day to worship you and to honor you and to glorify your holy name. We have no other God but you, Father. You are a faithful God. You are a mighty and loving God. We just worship in your holiness. We worship in your majesty. We worship in your splendor. We worship you in your holiness, Father. In Jesus' name we worship you. Amen. Thank you, praise and worship. Thank you so much. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord lift you. May the Lord be glorified in your lives. Your service is not in vain. The Lord loves you. You are a blessing to us. You are a blessing to this nation, to this church. You are a blessing to Bungoma. And we thank God for you. May He meet you at your point of need. Now this day, I want to thank God for yet another day He has given unto us. His servant David said that he was glad when he was told to go to the house of the Lord. And this day, I appreciate being in the house of the Lord. I appreciate everybody who is connected and who is concerned in this service. I appreciate the number one TV crew. I appreciate you. May the Lord God bless you so much. I want us again to learn of the Word of God. My name is Pastor Rebecca Shisoka, Brethren Fellowship Church. I want us to look at the Word of God from the book of 2 Kings, chapter 4. And from verse 1, we shall read through to verse 7. One day, I read in the name of Jesus, one day, the widow of a member of a group of prophets came to Elisha and cried out, "My husband who served you is dead, and you know how he feared the Lord. But now a creditor has come, threatening to take my two sons as slaves. What can I do to help you?" Elisha asked. "Tell me, what do you have in the house?" And Elisha said, nothing at all except a flask of olive oil," she replied. And Elisha said, "Borrow as many empty jars as you can from your friends and neighbors. Then go into your house with your sons and shut the door behind you. Pour olive oil from your flask into the jars, setting it one side when it is filled." So she did as she was told. Her sons kept bringing jars to her, and she filled one after another. Soon, every container was full to the brim. "Bring me another jar," she said to one of the sons. "There aren't any more," he told her. And then the olive oil stopped flowing. When she told the man of God what had happened, he said to her, "Now sell the olive oil and pay your debts, and you and your sons can live on what is left over." Praise the Lord. In the book of 2 Kings, chapter 4, verse 1 to 7, we are looking at the God of an immeasurable blessings, the God who blesses you in an immeasurable way, the God who is unlimited. Those who come into encounter with this God will never remain the same. When you come into encounter with the Lord of unmeasurable blessings, He changes your lives. He writes a new history in your life. He rewrites your story. And He rewrites your story. He makes it beautiful. He removes the story that you are under oppression. He gives you a new story. We have looked at this word of God in the book of 2 Kings. And we see this widow. This is a widow. And we know what it means to be a widow. Those who have seen widows in the society, this widow had suffered poverty. When the husband died, she suffered poverty. She suffered lack. She did not have what to eat. She borrowed. She lived on borrowing. She lived on debt. She was in despair. Every day, she could not add A to Z. She continued borrowing. And in the Jewish society, when you became a borrower, you became a slave to the people you borrowed. So it came a time when this lady had nothing to pay for the debt she had taken. So she said, the debtors wanted to take her sons as slaves to serve, to pay for the debt she had incurred. Before she had an encounter with God, this lady was living in abject poverty. She grappled with mounting debt. Her situation escalated until there was no other solution. The solution was that the sons should go and serve as slaves. You can imagine the situation. This lady is a widow, and the sons, they are threatening again to take the sons to serve as slaves, to take the sons from her. It was a pitiful situation. And we see, in the midst of all this, in the midst of this terrible situation, she had a divine encounter, at the end of which we are told that she met the man of God and she poured out her heart. She told the man of God, "I have debts, and my children, my sons are going to be taken away from me." And what do we see? This was the turning point for this lady, because there was nobody to show her mercy. There was nobody to sympathize with her. But on this particular day, she met the God of compassion. She met the God of mercy. She had an encounter with the God who has compassion over His people. And we see that on this day, after saying this, we see that she grew tired. This lady had grown tired of being in debt. So she decided to take a step. She said, I'm not going to remain like this. I'm going to approach a servant of God to connect him, to help me, to come out of this situation. And she took a bold step. She went and told Elisha, the servant of God. When she made that bold step, we see that her life did not remain the same. I want to encourage somebody. It doesn't matter the situation you are in. It doesn't matter the despair you have entered into. Just take a bold step and tell Jesus, I am tired of this situation. I want a change. I want to be lifted. I want to be changed. I want to be blessed. This lady, on this glorious day, she had an encounter with God. She had an encounter with the God of compassion. Where man had failed to show compassion, children of God, it reaches a time when no man is showing you compassion. When everybody is not showing you mercy, there is only one person who can show you mercy. And this is Jesus of Nazareth. He is full of mercy. God will show you mercy today. Maybe you've reached a point where nobody is looking at you, where people have given up on you, where even friends have run away from you. Because when they see you, they see problems. When they see you, they see trouble. But I want to encourage you today that when you take that step, when you go to Jesus, Jesus will see love. Jesus will shower you. Jesus will lift you. Jesus will rub that situation out of your life. You will have an encounter. It is not normal to eat from hand to mouth. This woman was eating from hand to mouth. And despite that, she had debts. She got tired of a situation. And this, she discovered the meaning of the words. Jesus said in John 10:10 that he will bless us. He will give us life. And not only life, he will give us life in abundance. This woman that day, we see the man of God instructing her. She asked, the man of God asked this woman, what do you have in your hand? I remember when God asked Moses, what do you have in your hand? Moses said, I only have a rod. It is that rod that God used to perform miracles in the land of Egypt. This woman is asked, what do you have? She has nothing. She just has a jar of flask, a flask that is full of oil. I don't even know whether it was full. I don't know whether it was empty. Maybe there were just remaining droplets. And she says, oh Lord, this is what I have, man of God. And the man of God tells her, go lock yourself and wait to see the miracles that God is gonna perform in your life. This woman obeyed the word of God. She went, she locked herself, she followed the instructions of God. She followed what Elisha, the man of God, had told her. And what do we see? We see that when God gives you instruction, maybe God has been telling you to do something and you just see it is foolish. You know, locking herself behind looked ridiculous. But what do we see? She obeyed. There are things in your life that God can tell you to do in order to meet your miracle. And you look at them as ridiculous. Today I want to encourage you. Listen to the voice of God and do exactly what God is telling you. God does not expect us to live in abject poverty. He is a God of immeasurable blessings. We see that this woman, after locking herself and doing exactly pouring the jars, she was told to borrow. This woman was so poor that she didn't have even the jars, but she was instructed to borrow from the neighbors, and all those jars were filled. And when they were filled, we are told it stopped flowing. We serve a God of immeasurable blessing. If this woman had jars as big as Bungoma County, they would have been full. I want to encourage somebody, let us stop limiting God. because we serve a God of immeasurable blessings. He is unlimited God. He has so many blessings. He has so many blessings for us. He wants to lift us. This woman had what I call divine encounter. When divine encounter takes place in your life, whenever you get tired of merely existing, time has come. We have to get tired of merely existing. God wants us to live. God wants us to be the head and not the tail. He wants to lead you. He wants you not to borrow. Children of God, I want to encourage somebody today that God will make you plenteous in goods. God does not only want to make you, your cup full. He wants your cup to be full and flow over. I'm sure this woman became a blessing to those people who were surrounding her, to those ones who had she had borrowed the jars from. Today I want to tell you, God wants us to overflow. The woman decided that I shall not continue. I shall not remain in this situation. I'm not going to remain poor. I'm not going to remain a borrower. The day you decide that enough is enough, God will start working in you, because we serve a God of immeasurable blessings. We serve a God of abundance. We serve a God who lifts you once and forever. The circumstances and problems of this woman pushed her into a breakthrough. I want to encourage somebody that those circumstances you are facing, do not sit down and start compromising with them. May they push you to your breakthrough. Don't accept problems to be part of your life. Today I want to encourage somebody to see God in your situation, to see God of abundance in your circumstances, to seek God and to say, God, enough is enough. I shall not live below. I want to live above. I shall not live in sickness. I want to live in health that you promised. I shall not live in crying. I want to rejoice. I shall not live in poverty. I want to be lifted. Today, this woman, when she came face to face with God, as soon as she encountered God, her situation changed. When you encounter this God of abundance, the God of immeasurable blessings, when you encounter this God, everything changes. It is time to get tired of your situation and to move out. As we continue finishing today, let the Lord bring you to that level that you have cried for. Let the Lord lift you. It is only God who can take you to that level. When a matter becomes desperate, you turn to God. This woman turned to God. The man of God instructed her. Today, as I finish, she was told to shut the door and stay in to meet her blessings. Today, I want to encourage somebody. When you want to encounter the divine experience, you need to lock yourself from outside influences. Just face God and be with God and say, God, you have remained my friend. Call upon the Lord, because he says, call upon me in the day of trouble and I will deliver you. Call upon the Lord who said, and there shall be no lacking in your life. Today, tell him what you need. Today, raise your heart and tell God what you need. May you receive a life-changing breakthrough as you encounter this God. May you receive, oh Lord, let me have an encounter with you today. May you have an encounter with God. May the Lord give you a giant testimony. Every reproach, every poverty, every death, lack of promotion, sickness, stagnation, today, we want to tell you your end has come, because we are meeting the God of immeasurable blessings, the God of immeasurable healing, the God of immeasurable uplifting. May he lift somebody today, wherever you are. I pray today, may your cup overflow. Father, in the name of Jesus, as I pray today, I bring your children before your mercy throne, Lord. Father, people have suffered. They have lived in poverty. They have lived from hand to mouth. Lord, today I pray, let that person there meet you, the God of blessings, the God of animation. immeasurable blessings. Let that person there meet you, the God of abundance. Let that person there meet your overflow. May the Lord lift you from that desperation to a situation that you will become a testimony. Let your testimony become big from today, that people may know that we serve the God of immeasurable blessings, the God who cannot be limited. Today, oh viewers, may you be blessed, may you be lifted, may you meet and encounter this God of immeasurable blessings. May you encounter this God who knows your situation. Today, as I finish, I bless you once more. May I remind you that this is Brethren Fellowship Church, and I am Pastor Rebecca Shisoka. My phone number is 07-10-178-204. We can pray together anytime. May you be blessed. May you be lifted. May you this week meet the God of immeasurable blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.